Hello learners, I am Dr. Priyanka Gautam, welcoming you at NIOS. Today we are going to discuss on a very important topic, that is a locomotion and movement. So we are going to discuss the senior secondary biology course. So let's go to the topic that the most important function of our body is that like we move. So the animal, those are moving, these are known as the motile organism, while those animals, those are not able to move, these are called as the sessile animals. So why we move? The movement is due to some major objectives, like we want to get the food, we want to move from one place to the another place to live, and we move away from the harmful conditions, that is we want to escape from the enemies, and we want to get the shelter, and the other purpose may be as for the mating and the reproduction. So these are the major purpose through which the locomotion or the movement taken place into the organism. So if we say that movement and locomotion, so generally we think that these both are the similar thing, but there is the difference in the movement as well as in the locomotion. The movement is the temporary or permanent displacement of a body or its part from the original position. So in the movement, the body is not moving. Body is like it's a part of the body is moving from the original position. While locomotion is it is the displacement of the entire body from one place to another place. So you can see that it is different. Movement is portion of the body, like I am moving my hand from here to here. So this is the movement. And locomotion, when I move from this position to the another position, complete my body is moving, that is the locomotion. So if we consider, there are the few examples like for the movement, like you stretch your arm or you pull your arm to take an apple or pick up an apple, that is the movement. And your tongue is also in motion when you are singing, when you are talking, so that is also a movement because it is the part of the body is moving. So it is a movement. And if we take an example of the locomotion, that is entire body of the organism, or like example like protozoans or the alga, they move away from its original position, it is under the locomotion. In the unicellular organisms like the bacteria and protist, specific organelles like the flagella and cilia are present, that is helping into the locomotion. Like in sperm, the male gamete have the flagellar tail by which they are moving from one position to the another position. And like in multicelled animals, mollusk locomote with their muscular foot and the starfish with the help of their tube feet. So birds are flying due to the muscles, and the other animals use the muscles to walk and run, and birds are using for their movement. Or locomotion. So the locomotion is like every animal has its different organ for their locomotion. So if we say that locomotion, so definitely some of the system of our body is helping into the locomotion. So that particularly include the skeleton function in the support, movement as well as for the protection. So skeleton provide the body support, movement by working with the muscles, and protection of the internal organ. So if we say the skeleton, it is helping into the movement. So there are the three types of skeleton, that is the hydrostatic skeleton, exoskeleton and endoskeleton. So hydrostatic is exoskeleton and endoskeleton. So endoskeleton, that is the bones inside the human hand or in our body, the whole skeleton system, that is the endoskeleton. And exoskeleton, that is the outer covering. So this is the shell outside the snail. And the hydrostatic skeleton is the one that is water pressure inside the earthworm. So it is protecting your internal side of the body. So as the three, the first one, this is the hydrostatic skeleton, example of the hydrostatic skeleton. The hydrostatic skeleton, it consists of the fluid held under the pressure in a closed body compartment, and it is found mostly into the worm and the cnidarians, and it protect our body part by cohesion them from the shock, and it also gives the body shapes as well as is provide the support for the muscle action. So next is the exoskeleton. You can see here in the grasshopper, it is containing the external covering, that is the exoskeleton part. And exoskeleton is the rigid external skeleton, and it consists like it is may be made up of like chitin and protein in the arthropods, and it may be made up of like calcium carbonate shells in the mollusk. The third type, that is the endoskeleton. You can see here there are the various animals that is containing inside the body structure, they are having a complete skeletal support. So that is the endoskeleton. So endoskeleton consists of the hard or leathery support element situated among the soft tissue of an animal. So this endoskeleton may be made up of like cartilage or cartilage and the bones like in the vertebrae, and framework of the tough protein fibers or the mineral containing particles like in sponges, and it may be like made up of hard plate beneath their skins like the echinoderms. So so this is the skeleton system that is actually supporting into the movement or locomotion of the animal. And if we go to the types of the movement for locomotion, there may be the different examples, like one is the ciliary movement. So cilia are the hair like very minute appendages, those are present to the external side of the body, external surface of the body. Some smaller organisms like the ciliate protozoas, in these the cilia help into the locomotion of an animal from one place to the another place. In animals, the cilia help to propel the fluid and the other material inside the body. So this is the ciliary movement that is present in a very important organism that is called the paramecium. So the paramecium move with the help of the cilia that is present all over its surface, and it is moving with the help of the effective stroke and then the recovery stroke. So they are moving in a very good manner with the help of the cilia. Then second type of the movement is the flagellar movement. Cilia, as we know that they are the very tiny structure, very small structure, but flagella is a more elongated and a long web like structure. So while cilia, it is covering the entire surface of the body, but flagellum is mostly present singly, or it may be present in a small number on the one end or to the two end also, or it may be present all over the periphery. So likewise, they may be known as the monotrichus, amphitrichus, lophotrichus and peritrichus on the basis of the presence of the flagellum, how many number are present. So flagella occur in a flagellate protozoans like the Euglena or the alga, and it may be like Cladomonas and other animals, sperm also. Sperm is also having the flagella through which it is moving or locomoting from one area to the another area. The flagellum beat in a symmetrical way or in the snake like manner and propel the water parallel to long axis of the flagellum. So the animal is also moving with the help of the flagella by the effective stroke and the recovery stroke. By this they are moving into a direction of the water. The another important type of movement that is present in the animals. So all activity that involve the movement, they are in the animal, they are dependent on the muscles. And we know that in the human body there are about the 650 muscles. And these muscles are helping into the various functions, like they are helping into the locomotion, they are helping into the to maintain your posture, they balancing on your two legs, and they also support the internal organs, while they are also controlling the different walls or the body opening of the system, and the muscles are also helping into the production of heat of the body, as well as the movement of the material along the internal tubes. So there are, you can see there are the number of the different functions of the muscle that is present into the animal. So they are very important into the locomotion phenomena as well. So, if we talk about the muscles, so what are the different types of the muscles? That is, it is major three types: the skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle. Of these, as we are talking about the locomotion, so locomotion, in the locomotion, the skeletal muscles are very important. So, let us go with the skeletal muscles. The skeletal muscles, these are the muscles that is attached to our endoskeleton. So, our body, because we have the endoskeleton, and our body of about 40% of the human body mass is of the skeletal muscles. So, skeletal muscles are mainly responsible for the locomotion, as well as they are also involved in the voluntary contraction and relaxation. So, these skeletal muscles, these are there are as three. So, this is very important in the locomotion, that is the skeletal muscle. The skeletal muscle is a form of striated muscle tissue which is under the voluntary control of somatic nervous system. And most skeletal muscles are attached to the bone by a bundle of collagen fiber, that is known as tendons. So, one bone is attached to the another bone with a bundle of collagen fiber, that is the tendons. And the skeletal muscle, as if we go to the structure, this is particularly contained, the skeletal muscle, the number of the nuclei. So, we can say that it is a multinucleated, and the plasma membrane, the outer membrane of this skeletal muscle is known as sarcolemma, and the cytoplasm that is present is known as the sarcoplasm. And they also varies into the, they have a particular length and as well as the diameter too. So, the skeletal muscles refers to the multiple bundle of the cells, they join together, they are known as the muscle fiber. So, the muscle fiber, that is muscle, that is made up of the number of the muscle fiber together, they join together. And these fibers are surrounded by the connective tissue, that connective tissue is known as the fasci. And the muscle fiber, these are long cylindrical structure and they have more than one nucleus. So, they are multinucleated and they also have the number of mitochondria as well, because they need the energy, the muscles need to function and function, they need the energy, and this energy is being provided by the mitochondria. So, the another important structure, if we talk about the muscle, is like you can see in the diagram, that muscle, that is made up of the muscle fibers. So, number of the muscle fiber together, they are making the muscle, and each muscle fiber that is containing a single unit is the myofibril. So, myofibril is very important, and this is the, that muscle fiber are in turn composed of the myofibrils. It is the elongated protein molecule and it is aligned in a parallel arrangement, and this is extended the full length of the cell. So, it is present along the full length of the muscle, and the this myofibril consists the protein chain. That protein chain is called as the myofilament, and myofilament have a symmetrical alternating pattern of the two proteins, that is the thick and the thin. The thick one is called the myosin and the thin one element is the actin protein. So, the myofibril, it is consist of the protein chain that is called myofibril, and myofibril is made up of the two protein unit is myosin as and the actin. So, myosin and actin actually important to the, into the muscle contraction for the movement of the animal. So, this myosin is the thick we call it as the thick myofilament. It consists the large number of the bundled myosin molecule. They are aligned in a overlapping manners. So, there are the hexamer of the protein of two identical, it is containing two identical heavy chains and two pair of different light chains. So, they are containing the regulatory light chain as well as the essential light chains. So, the myofilament, that is the thick, and it is the each myosin molecule, if we say, is that it is containing a rod like tail and two globular head. So, that it is containing tail and head. So, two tail is the two interwoven heavy polypeptide chain, they are bound together and pointed towards the M line, while the head they are containing the two smaller head. They are of made up of they are made up of light polypeptide chain that reaches out and grab onto the actin. So this is the myosin that is helping into the muscle contraction, and it is reaching to the actin molecule. So the next one, the important protein is the actin. This is called as thin myofilament. It is made up of two helically intertwined chain of the G actin or globular actin units, and this protein, it is containing two molecule, that is tropomyosin and the troponin complex. So these both together, in the presence of the tropomyosin and the troponin and also in the presence of calcium ion, these all together, they are helping into the muscle contraction process. So what is the muscle contraction and how the muscle contraction takes place? Like myosin and actin protein, they are definitely, they are the contractile protein. So they are helping into the interaction, and interaction of these actin and myosin, that is the thick and the thin filament, they are responsible for the muscle contraction. And if we say that actin and myosin, so they together, they are making a functional unit. So that functional unit of the myofibril is known as the sarcomere, and sarcomere is present in between the two successive dense linear structure, that is the that area is known as the Z line. So you can see here in the diagram that it is the thin filament, this is the actin, and the thick filament that is containing the tail and the head, and together the tail and head of the myosin and the actin filament, they together making a particular framework. So that framework, you can see here, there are the number of zones are formed. That zones are like Z line, and the one zone is the M line and H zone, and the so there is actin and myosin both together, they are making a functional unit, and that functional unit we are calling it as the sarcomere. Okay, so how the muscle contraction, what are the number of the phenomena takes place during the contraction of the muscle? So it occurs when there is a high number of the calcium. Okay, so because there are the two, as I told you, that tropomyosin and troponin, they function in the presence of calcium. So the calcium ion bind to the receptor of the troponin molecule, and then troponin tropomyosin complex change shape and move troponin out of the way and expose the active site of each actin molecule. So when the active site of the actin molecule is open, then the myosin can come and bind to the active site. So in that way, how the myosin action during the contraction, the myosin head, it has the two part, tail and the head. So head is interacting with the actin filament and making a cross bridge between the actin and myosin. Both they are making a cross bridge. The myosin head is interacting with the active site of the actin. So further in this process, this can be explained by a model that is known as the sliding model of the muscle contraction. So in this, the striated muscle contraction is explained by this particular theory that is known as the sliding filament theory. So this theory has a number of, we can explain it in a number of different steps. Like it may include the first one that has been initiated as the thick and the thin filament, myosin and actin are linked by the cross bridge of the troponin and tropomyosin. Then these cross bridge on contraction pull the thin filament back over the thick filament. So due to this result, a thin filament slides over the thick filament, and calcium and ATP are required for this particular process and also to release the troponin. Then because of this sliding, because both filament are sliding to each other, so because of this sliding, there are the number of zones. So in this zones, the Z lines come closer and the sarcomere becomes shortened, and then after that all sarcomere shortened together, so the entire muscle is contracted. So that all the sarcomere, when they are shortened, the muscle contraction is more happen. Then after this event occur throughout the sarcomere, the muscles shorten, and how the number of changes takes place, like Z line move more closer together, and the width of the A band remains same, and the width of the I band and Z zone also become shorter. So this is a particular diagram that is showing you how the sliding filament theory occur, and the how the actin is active site of the actin is binding with the head of the myosin, and how the movement of the actin molecule over the myosin. This is showing that how the shortening of the sarcomere takes place and the shortening of the bends, that is the A band. And these are the number of the steps, those are involved into the muscle contraction. So how the muscle contraction is being initiated, like first the impulse at the nerve ending of the muscle fiber. So muscle fiber is getting the stimulus, so muscle fiber then get stimulated. After the stimulation, the calcium ions are released outside. Once the calcium ion are there, the binding site of the actin filament is open, and then myosin bind to the actin molecule, and once it binds, it make the cross bridge, and actin and myosin now the slide over each other. So they move over each other, and then after that, when they are moving, the shortening of the muscle, that is contraction, and as a result muscle get contracted, and as the stimulus is not there, they again comes into the relaxed phase. So this is what happened during the muscle contraction. So learners, let we have a look on this video that is explaining you how the muscle contraction takes place, and how the number of changes takes place during the muscle contraction. Thank you. So learners, you see in this video how the different system are also interacting with each other. Like here the neuronal system is also interacting with the muscular system, that is helping into the contraction. So this is a very important process that is helping into our locomotion, where the contraction and the relaxation of the muscle takes place. So in this particular chapter, learners, we have learned about the number of the things like what is the difference between the locomotion and the movement, and what kind of system, that is the skeleton, it is helping into the locomotion and the movement, and the muscle specifically, those are helping into the locomotion, and how the muscles are helping into the movement of an animal or the locomotion of an animal through the muscle contraction. So thank you very much for your attention, and hope you enjoyed this particular part of the topic. Thank you.